for like the last 20 years.
Alright, I think we're all about ready to go.
Yeah.
Alright. Okay, here we go. I want to edit all that out later. And hey, it finally happened. Welcome to the first inaugural episode of Trip Guardians.
Oh.
how do I say that with a straight face? It's because it's not even my idea. It's actually that guy's idea next to me. This is a show that Gibby and I have been formulating for quite a while, where we get a chance to explore the King of Fighters and overall SNK community and competitive scene and a deeper level that we couldn't do on any other forum that we currently are attached to. I don't know why I'm talking about SDR like it's like, you know, a different entity. That's my show too, shit. Not allowed to mention SDR on a new show. So yeah, this is our chance to give a little bit more of a spotlight on players who we think deserve that spotlight, just don't really get a chance to get it because they're not playing other games, you know? They're not really they're not really connected with all communities. And we feel like KOF deserves it about as much as anybody else does. And so, you know, but, you know, as the old saying goes, you just got to pull yourself up by your own bootstraps. So,
of course,
this be the bootstrap. You are looking at the current cast, which is myself, Hell Pockets, and next to me is Gibby, who is currently sharing a studio with one Lord Walkman. You can see his, just dip your head in there. There you go. There he is. Love that guy. He's just like cram into like the frame or something like that. That'd be great. We call you guys the twins. And of course, my partner in crime in metaphysics, Meta Abe.
Yeah. Yeah.
And joining us tonight, you can probably hear him playing in the background, is one Arcade Shock Reynolds, and I'm going to bring him up without further ado because it's time for him to pay some bills.
What's up?
What's up?
I'm done.
Are you done goofing off over there?
I guess so.
Anyway, I just want to thank you for joining us. You're like on the first episode of Trip Guardians, and it's not really a big deal right now, but it's a big deal for me. I've been stressing about this all week. The last 2 days were extremely stressful for me. Yeah, so I'm going to try to have a little bit of fun with this because I can't, my back is like seizing up on me, so I can't like, you know, spend the entire episode railing you about shit. But I am going to ask you some tough questions after some easy ones. But why don't you introduce yourself a little bit, you know, tell us who you are, how you even got into KOF, and, you know, what you currently do for KOF.
What I currently do?
Yeah.
All right, let me start in the beginning. I got into, I guess, tournament standings. I started with 12. You know, nobody likes to talk about that game, but that's the game I started with in the tournament. And ever since then, I just stayed with KOF. Initially, I was a third strike player. I was really trying to get into that. And I didn't like 4, so I was like, you know what, I don't want to play this game, I'm just going to play KOF. And that's where I started, basically.
Okay, yeah. And then, and so now you've won EVO 2013, like, that's something that, I don't think there's been a crown for KOF in America at EVO since.
Well, you still have Marble. MVC3. Well, I don't know if that counts or not.
I mean, it doesn't. It counts for EVO wins, of course, but it doesn't count for like KOF. You know, like we.
Oh yeah,
not,
that's true.
We have not taken the gold from the world since 2013.
No. So we haven't.
You are the lone standard right now, man. You're the official EVO champ of America.
That's true.
Yeah.
What's up with that, man?
I don't know. Like, do you ever like? Does that
everyone
ever like?
Else got to step up their game.
Do you ever like wake up in the morning?
Can't rely on me.
Do you ever like wake up in the morning and you're just like, yeah, I did win EVO 2 years ago or three years ago.
Hello.
Do you ever like wake up and you're just like, yeah, I'm the KOF 13 champ. Nobody else can claim that in this country.
No. I think about the future, I don't think about the past.
Damn.
Dude, but I wake up and I think, man, Reynolds the KOF champ.
when I wake up. Hey, guess I mean, awesome.
Nothing comes to mind when I wake up other than that. Is just, man, good old Champion Reynolds. He really did it.
He made a straight up comeback, bro.
Oh, man. You know what's funny? I had dinner with my friend yesterday for a birthday. And he was telling me, like, one of these, what's that one game, that shooting game that everyone's playing right now?
Battlefield?
Overwatch.
Oh.
It's like an Overwatch streamer was talking about me yesterday.
What?
I was like, what?
Oh, we made it? We made it?
Yeah. I guess. I don't know. I don't know if he's popular or not. I don't know who this guy is.
I mean.
What? He's got crossover appeal? Jeez. We're so lucky?
That's legit. Oh, yeah, man. That's actually pretty good.
Yeah, man. He's like, yeah, the best tournament he's ever seen was my match. I was like, what?
Oh, yeah. A lot of people actually come up to me and tell me that, actually.
That match is pretty crazy, though. I mean, you were about to lose. I think, how far down were you? Like,
I was 2-0.
Yeah, it was match point or tournament point for him, right?
Yeah.
Yeah,
like,
wow.
Maybe twice or three times, maybe. Yeah, that was nuts.
That's when you pulled out Takuma at the end, right?
No, I pulled out Kyo.
Oh, right.
I didn't have him the first two games. I was using Kim on point.
I actually remember you pulled out Takuma, and I was kind of like, what? Is this like trying to like, and you confirmed it afterwards, but I remember thinking like, is this like him trying to do like the Bala moment? Or he has like, he just pulls out Takuma and then like does the reverse OCV with Takuma. And then afterwards, you're just like, how come you didn't go crazy on the mic? Because I pulled out Takuma. And I was like, oh, see, like, I didn't take the bait. That's fine.
You should have, man.
I was like, nah, he's got a Takuma, right? Yeah. And Abe's just like, I don't know, man.
And it's like, he's got one of those? He's got one of all of them. I hope it works.
Yeah. So, and, I mean, you pulled out the EX kill, and we're just like, all right. That's good.
That's so crazy because from the looks of the match, it looks like you just started freestyling.
Yeah.
Well, he wasn't Wu was not blocking anything at that time, so he kind of gave you the opportunity to do it, you know?
No, he was blocking everything. I started using Kyo and I started throwing him. I don't know if you remember, I threw him like 4 times in a row.
Okay, so that's actually something that I want to bring up next. What was it like to play him the entire time? Like, walk us through that, if you remember anything from it, if it's not like a huge blur.
I really thought that Kim was going to be a good matchup against Rio. Just on paper, if you're playing footsies against Rio, like, Kim is supposed to beat him. But I guess just the way I was playing, it wasn't suited for that match. So I went with the character that was more suited to how I was playing at that moment, which was Kyo. Mm-hmm. I wanted to go nuts, and he's the perfect character for me to do that. I was paper or my instinct. I guess my instinct wins. So.
I mean, yeah, I can definitely see where... I won't say that you stopped thinking, but you definitely started taking a few more risks than I was used to taking once you picked EXKO. I mean, it all paid off, and clearly he hadn't seen that character yet, you know? At least not enough of it. And,
no, I don't think so.
I mean,
there's a few people in Japan that were using it at the time, but they weren't really optimizing his movement.
Right.
I think that really made the difference, the way you're moving, because he couldn't really lock you down, and it was really frustrating him. Like, he's the type of player that's like, oh, well, you're in this area. Well, he automatically already does a certain thing. You know, he already knows the options really, really well as a player. So when those options start to seem like they weren't available, he started to kind of crumble.
Correct. Not only with Kyo, that also fell with Benny, because he knew that the idle kick was punishable, right?
Yeah.
But I made him seem, I guess how some of my friends like to say it, I stole some of his frames Yeah, he wasn't able to react to the unsafe stuff that I was doing. I mean, he was a couple frames late. I remember he did EX against Benny versus Kim. He did EX ground hug against Suzanne. That was supposed to punish my Aedo kick, but he just did it too late. All I did was block. It was an easy punish, but he just did it too late. So he was, I just forced him to think about way too many options, and he couldn't react to all of them.
That's totally what it is, and you and I have talked about that a lot, that sometimes people can get overwhelmed by just thinking about all the options that are available, especially after you've been failing to shut certain things down.
Yeah, exactly.
And that's actually pretty big into what ended up happening in the second half of that that match, where, I mean, I don't know if you were conscious of it or not, but there was a moment where you were just like 100% confidence, I think. And
oh, that began after my fourth throw.
Yeah.
So I knew I was gonna win after that.
Like,
I mean, I still had a chance of losing, but that was like the back of my mind. Like, that was not, I wasn't even thinking about that anymore.
Like, basically the only thing that could have turned you off was if he started teching a throw. And then you'd be like, okay, maybe he's learning a little bit. But he wasn't, like, he just was not ready for anything. And and then it got to the point where, and this happens to me all the time, where I'm just like, I'm feeling it so much that I'm just like, screw it, you know? Like, I'm up a character, I'm up a couple games, you know? Yeah, sure, I'll do, like, far stand D into activation without even confirming.
Yeah.
Yeah. A lot of people remember that moment because that was probably the most insane way to open up a such a high intensity round, and of course, because I dropped the F bomb, so
yeah. I dropped the combo too.
And then you dropped the
combo, and then I got it back.
You got it. That's why I swore. I wasn't swearing because you activated. I was swearing because you got it back like immediately afterwards, and I'm like, what the fuck, man?
you couldn't complete your sentences with normal words, and you're just like, fuck.
Oh man, but yeah, that was such an awesome match. And moving forward, you know, now you're doing like huge things in KOF 14, and all your, you know, you've had every tournament you've been to, you had a top 8 showing over at SoCal Regionals. You almost took it. You were definitely my favorite to win that.
I wasn't ready to win.
Is that what happened?
I thought I was, but I wasn't.
So obviously you were in the position to win that.
Yes.
You pulled out Chin. And it didn't look like Shaohai was quite ready for Chin. And
no, I don't think it was.
Yeah, I don't think he was. I don't think he's ready for him now. But I think, I mean, that last before round before the reset, obviously, like neither one of you saw that coming. You know, I can't imagine that didn't put you on tilt just a little bit.
Oh, which part?
When you almost clinched it, and then it just kind of got away from you. You know,
I dropped that chin combo like twice in the same match, or not in the same match, but in that set. I mean, I didn't practice that link enough, I guess. Mm-hmm. The timing on it is a little bit weird. His down B, down A, down B, down A link is there's a specific timing for it. You can't just like mash it, you know.
Is that is that something that is actually that beneficial though for using, like, or is that just something that you just were trying to get comfortable with using?
What do you mean, the combo, like, or are you talking about,
like,
the character?
What's the, like, why, if you got the confirm after, like, you know, maybe down B, why would you just not cancel in the special instead of going for another couple of normal?
Oh yeah, tests? that's very beneficial for him because
it dropped again.
Yeah. Oh.
Your voice. It's okay. You're back. Repeat that last part.
Yeah, he gets at least an extra 300 damage
if I
do an activation.
Okay. Well, then there you go. Shit. But yeah, that's something that, you know, Abe and I and pretty much everybody else here, like, you know, we've seen you do similar issues, have similar issues like that in previous matches, and like in KOF 13 at SoCal Regionals, I want to say 2014, 2015. Mm-hmm. Where same character, you're playing Cannibalito with Chin, and you're going for the same setup like four times in a row, and he's blowing it up. And
yeah.
Is that something where you're just like, I want this to work, or I want to know exactly why this doesn't work, and I don't care that it's grand finals?
A little bit of both. It's a little bit of both. At that point, it's kind of like my brain shuts off, and I just want it to work.
Do you think, because I've seen you play a lot, and these things do happen to you, unless it's one of those things where it's like you really want to earn it.
Yes.
Like, because it's like this. You start developing an endurance because you play so much. You know, you're really trying to get better. But I notice in those tournaments that you played that, I know that you haven't been playing that much, like, in those tournaments. And then when you get into that, you start to autopilot, and it's like you can't, like, manually steer the fucking plane because you're like, fuck, I can't get out of this autopilot. Like, I keep doing it over and over again. Mm-hmm. And, like, it just, you don't have the mental strength to pull yourself out of that.
Yeah, pull myself and create a different option for myself. Yeah. I mean, I'm known to create options for myself, but in those situations where I'm just like burnt, lazy, I just want this thing to work. I want it to hit once, twice. I'll just keep doing it. I don't know. I guess that's one of my weaknesses, but that's from the lack of training in general, you know. Mm. And I know it. Like I said, I wasn't ready to win.
And it was interesting, too, because after that happened, Shanghai went and won Street Fighter, right?
Yeah.
And I was thinking about it. I was like, whoa, that's so fucking crazy how this guy can do that and still have enough mental stamina after going through matches with you to go through all of Street Fighter V and win. And it's like, dude, like, this guy either plays a ton, and it's like he's not using that much of his brain that he could just do it. Because it's like, you, to me, are like either the best when you have all the juice, or it's like once you start to go off and you don't have any mental energy, it's like you go down like 20 levels.
Well,
like, it's crazy.
The stamina part, he's been playing for like what, forever?
Yeah.
Right? KOF in general, he has so many years of experience. Oh, that's also another reason why I lost them. Not because of his experience, but I kind of underestimated him going into Grand Finals. He had really bad habits. Was it top 16 when I played him?
Yeah.
Going into the top 8. I didn't expect him to actually adapt in Grand Finals because of all of his experience, all the years he's been playing KOF, I thought he would stick to his bad habits. But while I was playing him, everything that I did to him the previous night, he didn't get hit by. Like, he knew. Like, I knew the specific moments where he was supposed to do something, and then I even read it in his head that he said, no, don't do this here. I even knew he said that to himself while playing him, because I could see the hesitation of his movement. Because he knew if he did that certain thing right there in that show the night before, he was getting hit by everything because of his bad habits. Mm-hmm. And again, I was expecting him to not change those habits because of his experience, his long experience with KOF. And it surprised me in Grand Finals that he was able to get a hold of his own bad habits, basically. Which is what I was playing him off of, and I knew during the match those certain situations were about to happen again, and he just stopped himself. Like, I knew, I read his mind. He was like, "Hey, don't do this because he's gonna hit me with this right here in this situation," and he really held back in general. Like, all of the bad habits that he had. And, you know, I was kind of hoping that he'd play a little bit more wild. Like the day before. But, he's a smart player. No, like, again, I wasn't ready for that. I thought I was, but I wasn't. So, it's a great learning experience.
Okay, so obvious question now is that you've qualified for the World Championship Series, whatever the hell that means. Now it's you, Shaohai, Daco, I believe.
Daco won?
Daco got, didn't he qualify in Canada Cup?
Did he win?
I think or he got second, though. He got second.
Daco got second. Third was Vizio.
Vizio. So I guess they'll have another qualifier somewhere else and to pick a fourth player, maybe. But you guys are going to meet again. You and Shaohai are going to meet again probably at the World Championships. Mm-hmm. What do you think? You think you got them this time? You think there's going to be any need for any further improvement for you before, like, you know, either leading up to it? I mean, like, you know,
there's always need for improvement in this game. Like, you have to refine your skills. I mean, I don't really want to do this, but I guess my example would be like, you know, samurais in Japan back in the days, right? They'd always train. Regardless if they're a master class, they're always going to be training. Right?
Mm-hmm.
It's the same thing. You can't slack. Because if you start slacking, then you become overconfident and you start messing up in those little situations and you start doubting yourself. And then that's where you lose.
You get out of shape. Yeah, man.
Yeah.
So I assume going into it, you are not assuming anything then.
Well, the only assumption I had, I mean, are you talking about SCR?
No, I'm talking like after post SCR, you see Shaohai at KOF World Championships. You don't have any assumptions about beating him.
Assumptions about beating him?
Or, yeah, just in general. Like, you know, like you said.
I'm going to win type of thing?
Because you've definitely like, in the past been like, you know, say, oh, yeah, I got this, you know? And, you know, 60% you do. So, I mean, it's not a bad ratio. But, like you said, at SoCal Regionals, you underestimated him and his ability to adapt and to continuously perform. Mm-hmm. Obviously, you can't make that, you know, mistake again. But you also can't go into it scared.
Oh, well, do I look scared?
No, I don't think you're scared. That's what I was asking. Like, how do you feel about it? Like,
how do I feel about it? It's going to be work. It's not easy being a top player in general because of the training that you need to do. And I need to, I mean, I've already done it. I think I already have my characters, my four or five characters that I'm going to use post-patch. So, you know, I got to start from the bottom, you know, got to pick my four to five characters and then start training those characters, making sure get all my hit confirms down, my combos down, no matter what the situation is, no matter who I'm playing. So that's part of practice. Mm. Once I get those down, then, you know, I can only rely on that.
Is it one of those things where you'll only know once you start playing them? Like where you stand?
Well, not only playing in general or practicing in general, there's also studying him as well. I mean, not only him, but like the people who are going to be attending the event. You know, I need to step up my game in terms of studying, because I hate studying. You know, nobody likes studying, right? School,
yeah,
fucking hate that shit, right? Yeah, it's gonna be tough. It's gonna be a lot of fun too. I mean, this is what, you know, this is why I play games. Mm-hmm. I love the challenge.
That's good. I think you have one of the more healthier mentalities of higher level players that I see today, because a lot of people see it as just straight work and they hate it. You know, like, look at how many people, I mean, I don't want to bring up Street Fighter V in a KOF show because it's irrelevant to us, but like, you know, like a lot of people just seem to not be having fun with it. And I still think the game is very fun, but I think they've allowed it to get to the point where it's just like, oh God, like I can't eat, you know, this is my shit. They're going to take my shit, you know, like, like it's still gotta be fun for you, you know. Like Justin definitely keeps a very positive like attitude about Street Fighter in general, and I think that's why he continues to do well in it, because it's just like, well, I mean, it's gonna shake out one way or the other. Why shouldn't I enjoy myself?
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, anybody else got any questions for him? Like, I've been, me and Abe have been kind of running this.
I don't know. I was just kind of thinking about, like, your approach to, like, character choices and stuff like that. Because you always seem like a person who really kind of just, like, goes through, you know, all the characters, kind of feels out what you like, what you don't like out of them. But, like, ultimately, what makes you decide on who you want for your team or who you have in the on the back burner? Like, are there, like, characters that you have that you don't normally play, but if, like, your main team isn't working, like, what deficiencies are you trying to make up for when you pick your characters?
It really depends on the character's tools. You know, there's a lot of characters in this game that doesn't have a really good DP.
Mm-hmm.
And as you guys see, I haven't used any characters with DPs, basically.
Yeah.
Not in a sense where you could just DP on startup and they're completely invulnerable. I mean, Nock, she doesn't have a DP, but she has the bird pre-patch. that was kind of a DP, but, you know, not really.
Yeah.
It was a safe option for her. I like characters that forces my opponents to think. That's what I like. I like challenging my opponent and then seeing their answer. If they can beat my challenge, or if they can't. That's the type of characters I like using. I also like making myself work for whatever reason. I don't know why. That's just who I am. That's the characters I use. Like, you know, people say Kyo's top tier. I still don't think he is. I think he's like 13 EX Kyo, but slower in this game.
Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah, he's good, but he still has, you know, weakness. I think so. Iori's still better than him.
So yeah, I mean, is there like a typical go-to character that like, or not necessarily go-to, but like on your main team or whatever, you know, are there characters that you think about rotating out more, and then some that just won't ever leave the team? You know what I mean?
What I was trying to do for 14 was try to use new characters that nobody's really using. Mm-hmm. As you can see, I was using Mian. I was pretty much the only Mian player, along with Mr. KOF, but he didn't show up to the tournament.
Right.
I like using those type of characters. Because Mian's also, even though she's low tier, she doesn't have a lot of options on Wake Up. If you give her the room, she'll force you to, you know, challenge her.
Mm-hmm.
She forces you to do that.
Yeah, because it's definitely not something you can just, like, play wait and see and be like, I'll block and keep doing all this stuff. It seems like you really do kind of have to.
If you keep doing that, if you keep doing that, I'm going to take advantage of that. I'm going to see that, right?
Build a lot of meter, get some chip, you know, maybe just have the life lead and run away.
Yeah, exactly. If you saw Cannibalito, I haven't played him with my Mian up until SCR. That was the first time I played him with using my Mian. He already had a strategy against her, but I was able to quickly adapt because I'm already used to having or thinking about answers to what they have for me.
And that's good.
that's also part of my character choices. It allows me to already have options, even though I've never seen their options before, create options in my head or create scenarios while I'm playing. Hey, he does this. I can try this.
Okay.
If it works, you know, so, and then I learn from it.
Yeah. So essentially, it's like you play the character, you kind of understand the basics, but then you see what your opponent's doing, and then you try and maybe like go adjust out there, it. Yeah, and just be like, okay, well, I know that I can do this, but I could also do this. So yeah. Just trying to really apply what works, what doesn't,
Just change up my timing just a little bit, just to throw them off. I don't know if you saw, but against Cannibalito, I changed up my timing by a couple frames on my dive kicks, and that threw him off too.
Yeah, definitely.
So, I mean, that's part of my fun in video games. Like, I mean, winning isn't everything, but, you know, having fun.
What are you talking
definitely
about?
Part of it.
I mean, if you didn't like it, I'm sure you wouldn't do it. So
no, exactly.
How about you, Gibby? You got anything?
No. You and Abe asked the question I was going to ask.
Oh, okay. Cool. Well, I think you guys ready to throw down, spill some blood?
If we can get this room running fine, yeah.
Is the room good? I'm still in it.
Let me try to get in it.
Have you not been able to?
No.
Yeah, if not, Abe's going to have to make the room.
Ah, okay.
Send an invite again?
All right. Now we're going to come to the portion of the show where we put the guest of honor in the hot seat against the members of Game Goons. Hopefully, he doesn't go easy on us because, you know, we definitely don't deserve it. please abuse us, Reynolds Sano.
Okay.
If I don't get OCV'd, I'm going to be disappointed until you go back to the... Go back to the drawing board.
You're not ready for Shanghai, man. Pool right now.
Jeez, Viscount.
Wait, no, hold on.
Not Reynolds, jump in.
Yeah, I'm here. The bottom.
Jump in the
tournament. Yeah. I say, don't scare me like that.
Alright, everyone good?
All right, we're good. Good to go. Alright. And I've got a little handy here, a little camera to look at Reynolds' buttons while he plays.
Okay.
I think I did. Did you not see it?
Why you want to see my button?
Just curious.
Trying to cheat here or something?
They're like, right.
There you go. Yeah, just keep it right there for a second.
You see, just for one match.
Okay.
6-2. Really?
Mm-hmm.
I'm so sad. Viscount says the Raiders have the biggest balls of any team in the NFL. We set the record for penalties and won anyways.
Mm-hmm. Viscount says a freaking Raider? Jesus.
The best.
I mean, he's from SoCal.
Isn't he from San Diego, though?
He's from Raider Nation.
I think no self-respecting football fan is a Chargers fan.
You need to fix that. No self-respecting human being.
Oh, well, Reynold over there throwing the Ganyo, huh? Oh, that's real.
Damn, nice.
But, you see, I saw him throw Mui Mui there, and I'm just like, wait a minute. Is this the same match as last time? Like, what's going on?
Hey, what the hell? You have so much practice against the Gangyo, like best Gangyo in the world. Did you lose to this guy?
Dude, but you're not whiff punishing
him. Oh, what's going on? The Reynolds factor got you jumping on Shaka Shoe.
Shaka Zulu.
Shaka Zulu. Shaka on the wall still. Uh-oh.
Okay. So you know what I think is pretty funny is how they were like, Antonov can't have this giant back EX, but Andy's EX elbow, that's fine.
Oh yeah. He
can keep that. But Antonov, that character was too strong.
Holy
Andy's
shit.
Secret top tier.
Wow. Oh, be too good.
That's a heartbreaker when you don't get to follow up before it'd be.
Yeah.
I didn't see Tom Petty anyway, what are you talking about?
Slapping buttons!
Look at that neutral jump. I'm just gonna bring up every time these guys neutral jump because it's amazing.
Ow, why does that do so much damage?
That didn't do much.
That does pretty good damage.
Well, he only had like 25%?
Yeah, less than 300. Round 4.
Ready? Go! Well, shit. Oh! Oh, man. Benny Mark sucks.
That was only level 2?
Yeah.
Benny is definitely not that good.
Ow!
Ow! Oh man, he did it again. It's like 2013 all over again.
For those who don't know, this game has the same problem 14 had or 13 had, where when you press two buttons at the same time, it doesn't come out 100% of the time.
Yes.
Why you get annoying things like that where Abe did level 2 super, but got level 1? So frustrating. All right, Chris, you ready?
That's why I have an EX button.
Am I up or is Tony up?
It's you.
Okay.
Let me get out of here. I get in and don't start yet.
Nope.
Okay,
alright. Reynald, do you want to readjust your camera or do you want to keep it on your buttons?
I'll do it one more. It's fine, whatever.
Okay. I'm looking at that shit.
Okay.
Wow.
You,
hmm?
You can change the buttons.
I can?
Yes, I told you that last night, like 5 minutes.
When?
During water. So before you start the match, just press start and go. You kept saying it was fine. I got it.
I'm trying to learn that rainbow style, man.
It was all for you. I learned a little bit. I feel slightly more confident with it, but I'm still hitting light kick when I'm trying to hit light punch and vice versa. So. Oh yeah, what do you think about verse, Reynolds?
It's pretty good. I mean, I used them pre-match.
Yeah, because I saw there was that, what was it, that North Japanese tier list or whatever, and they put them up there on super cheap and really good. Not Leona good, apparently.
No.
That's safe.
Sometimes.
Speaking of which, have you been playing RJ at all? How's his Leona?
No.
I played him, but no.
No, I don't play him.
Nah. Reynald, don't let him throw fireballs at you. Just stomp the ground.
What?
His stomp negates projectiles.
It does?
Yeah, it only negates.
I tested it pre-patch and it didn't work.
Oh, pre-patch?
Yeah, we don't talk about the Dark Ages, dude.
Yeah. Oh no! Oh no!
Hey, how happy were you about the way the normals started working for Gangnam?
Oh, I'm so happy. Because Evo, I was expecting so much from him.
Yeah. Dude, I know.
When the Evo came and I was playing him, I was like, oh my god, this sucks.
Right? Like, immediately you're like, dude, this blood suck.
I'm like, why doesn't this work? It should work.
You know, the only thing that made me happy about him was like, hey, I bet you he could do this, I bet you could do that. I was like, how are you figuring this stuff out? I'm like, it's like Marco the Wolf, the only game I play.
Oh, you can get 3 jackknives?
Holy shit!
Alright, I'm a jackknife.
You got a perfect on you!
Damn it! It's alright, I got a Joe victory, it's all that matters to me. Fuck! Nelson sucks, man!
Ooh, amazing party.
Biddy Morrow is not good! Why is it working? Biddy Morrow sucks, bro! You're not doing it right. No.
The 3 out of Gary is pretty amazing.
He got stunned twice?
Yeah, did he stun you twice?
Oh my god! I started out so strong.
Do you want to start?
I'll give it to you.
I think Abe is going to play.
I'll jump.
Abe, it's, okay. Yeah, it's happening for me.
We're good to go.
So, go.
Hold on, don't go in yet.
Go to what?
Go and don't start. I'll start.
Hold on. Start. Okay.
No.
Oh, options, you mean?
Start options. It says start.
Okay, you want to do it then?
Yeah, sure. Okay,
I think you can still do it, right? No, you can't do it here. Yeah.
No, he can't do it from here. Yeah.
All right, so Gibby's gonna play.
Okay.
Okay.
I need some juice. Shit.
Awesome juice.
Like juice. Literal juice.
Literal juice.
It's like, yeah, I was telling my mom how I want to be like a competitive fighting games, and I was like, I think I'm gonna have to start juicing, mom, because this is not.
I need some PEDs, some HGH to give me, and get my execution on point.
Just to hang, not even to win. Just hang.
By the way, Reynold, I want to say your connection is a lot better.
Yes. It is. Right. I'll get them. Nice. Look at my butt.
Oh. Yeah, when you threw me on wake up, I tried to short hop A, but I didn't get the jump.
Oh.
And I'm sad. So very sad. Because I like playing Gang-Yo. He's fun.
He is fun.
I was so happy when I saw his, like, set and everything. And then I saw everything else about him. I was sad, like when I played him at Demo.
I was just noticing how his pants are a better model than Kim's. Yeah.
Kim's pants don't do shit. Oh, you piece of shit.
You see how bright Kim's teeth are and his V? You know he's like extra starches that. Like, don't. He's too clean, man.
I need that crease to be perfect.
Gang-Yo looks like he has like hand wraps that has been on for like 2 months.
Well, he's got those Kung Fu hand wraps.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you, Apex.
I get it, bro. Does he have glass on him?
Goddamn crouch. Oh, what the fuck is that? Oh, I rolled him, I got nothing. Alright, dinosaur. Time to do things. Can you do
that? Should be able to.
Better be able to. Oh, jeez.
Off to an amazing start.
Yep.
Wow, I didn't get it. That catches the short house almost all the time.
Oh, here we go, baby.
Oh, God. I like the roar sound.
Oh, no!
Yeah, I should have done jumpsuit, whatever. It's fine.
He's back. It says caution, electricity.
Alright, let me hold on a second. Hold on.
Yeah,
that's you.
Okay. By the way, I just want you to know that, you know, a kill icon in KOF 14 is pretty much a Twitter egg.
Well, 13?
He probably did say 13.
That's a 14.
Oh.
Did I say 13?
Yeah. He said 14.
14? 14.
Also, in case you guys haven't, we need to hit about, 100 subscribers to make our YouTube channel legit.
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to find it. Jesus, it's so hard to find it. That's why we need to make it legit. Yeah, so if you guys haven't already, you guys can subscribe to our YouTube channel. I'll link it right now.
Alright, guys.
14 more.
If you like what you see here today, or you want to see other similar videos, like, follow, and subscribe. You can also find us at Game Goons TV on Twitter, where you can find all the latest Game Goon news.
Oh, shit. Whoops.
Congratulations!
Player one wins! My bad, homie.
Richard Meyer. Alright, Nelson,
ready,
time to sign.
Two, ready, go!
Had it! Go! I'll tell you.
Amazing. Player two wins.
This might be a bad matchup for Nelson.
That's crazy.
That crossed up?
Yeah.
Holy shit!
Pop, pop, pop.
Is Benny Maru a strong character? Find out after the jump.
You got punished. I think it was like the first time you ever got punished for that.
Make sure you turn off ad block, folks.
Jesus.
Hey, come out.
Round four.
We're gonna start a Kickstarter soon, trying to buy ourselves a house. It's gonna be sweet.
Game Boone's house?
Yeah.
It's called a dumpster in the back of the the back of the Olive Garden. You know, they have so much free pasta that they know they throw most of that away.
Not even, man. I wish it would be Olive Garden. It's more like the Golden Corral.
Hey, Golden Corral's fine. They got good roast beef. Alright, official tier list of the two places I've had. Golden Corral definitely beats Hometown every day. Hometown sucks.
Hometown is depressing. Like, the people that eat there are depressing too.
Everything was perfect. Poor Hometown. You were never good, but now it's like, this ain't no home I want to live in. This house is not a home.
I remember one of my bosses asked me to go to Hometown, and I was like, I looked at him, and I was like, man, you would go there. You're a sad man.
Oh shit! What?
It's the only place
What's
I can
happening?
Chocolate milk while I eat my Jello and mashed potatoes.
I think I'd rather go to Sizzler.
What the hell?
Yeah.
And what get happened? Their buffet. Or their salad bar shit. Just eat shitty pizza all day.
Jesus Christ.
Okay, so options.
Mm-hmm.
It's not start anymore, bruh. See? On the bottom right-hand corner. Options.
We're not playing Gradius.
Oh, man. I wish I had Gradius options. Imagine Daimon with options where just, like, out of the little dot, like, his arms just come out and punch you in the face. Just grabs you full screen. Just
so you can just, like, set play down 4T, everyone?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. See, just
you know, you see Ross eating someone to get him in the corner, run forward, and then just like backdash so that you just cover the whole screen.
Nah, I ain't dealing with that shit.
Why does he say Zoe?
It's not gonna negate those things.
Man, Andy's real cheap. Just saying.
He's sulking. She's soaking. The neutral.
Oh dear. Wow. That last hit does a lot of damage.
Yeah, it does the good damage.
He needs it.
Oh, he needs it. He really needs it.
He wasn't doing shit before that.
Yeah, tell me about it.
Artistic finish.
Round
Ooh. Man, Mini Marvel just doesn't have to take shit from anybody.
He's pretty much like that in every game.
Yeah. Like, the only person I think that can give him like shit in this game is probably like... probably Mac, pre-patch Mac maybe.
Stop making up here.
Oh, excuse me.
The greatest Taekwondo team member, Trans Am.
Trans
Am. We got, you know, Jun and Kim, Gong Il, Trans Am.
Hey, Reynald, Renz wants you to play a kill.
Sure. But I want to play Gong Il.
So,
so drop him off.
Yeah, play a worse character. Give us a chance to.
Oh no! What?
Abe, it's okay, don't worry. I was saving evidence.
We got reaction guys. It's cool.
In a shocking finish.
Jesus.
Options?
Alright, options, man. You gonna do it?
Options. Yeah, it's working. Boom, 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 boom. Wreck.
No.
Whoops.
Yeah, now I'm good.
Ha ha! That took way too long. I'm dead. I'm a dead man.
You know what? See, Anthony's been playing my account last night and right now. It's gonna ruin my record.
Oh, yeah.
You're gonna be say goodbye to Diamond League.
It's over.
Oh yeah, baby. Give him that Rio.
Okay, I'll block. You have to be patient with this guy.
Oh, bollocks.
Oh, bollocks.
Oh. Gut punch.
Yeah. Dude, that fireball's so terrible.
Hell yeah.
I thought they would have buffed it too, man. Like... Sick.
Damn, that shit ain't real.
No! Keep getting blown up by the follow up of the stomp. I did not expect it to happen.
Lord Walkman with the accidental genius. Just like,
you can DP.
No, you're right. I probably does punish it. I just think it's not punishable, but I have nothing backing that statement up. Oh dear. I was thinking about it, but I'm thinking like, all right, he's actually disrespecting me a lot, so I probably could get away with this, unlike you guys. You guys are just like, this guy's a dumbass. He'll do it four times on Waco. I'm trying to play solid from now on, guys. No more of this wild shit.
That's what we do here in gaming, is everybody, we lie to ourselves. Okay.
Well, this isn't a good one for old geese. I have to see. Yo, this is how it goes. This is my life.
He was like, "What's up, bro?
Gibby's like, how come you're not doing that thing? You know, like, hey, when you robbing that bank? Oh, thanks, Gibby. Like, I had to hand him the gun in my pocket. Sure.
Whoa, that's far range. What the fuck?
Hell no, it ain't. Don't you even lie to me right now.
Don't believe me. This is a guy that said Geese has bad buns.
I didn't say that, I just said I didn't like the way they felt.
What did I get in the face? Yeah. Oh, Jesus. Bah, bah, bah.
He's like, get that shit out of here!
No! Not like this! No, he's the third character, damn it! I messed up my combo that was supposed to be command grabbing the Neo Max and everything. Fine Max, whatever. They're all. I was gonna be Max.
Max something.
Uh-huh. Max Punish.
Max Powers.
This guy. Oh, this,
boop right. That guy.
We've got time for three more, I think, and then we have to retire to the
boop
green
that
room.
Guy.
Still one more patient. Hold on. Who's
the name?
Boot.
He's got three bars.
We gotta get out of here.
Hold on. Don't start it yet.
Oh shit!
Oh shit!
They're all covered in. They found us.
I don't know how they found us. Click on them. Oh, you're not the. Whoa. Abe has to kick.
Oh, Abe?
I do?
Yeah. It's your room.
Look at this guy want to start his own match right now. What a piece of
get
shit.
Get out of here.
Trying to film a show right now, you piece of
get
shit.
Get out of here. Oh, I can't kick him.
It's because he's probably in the tourney thing.
Oh.
Whatever. Just go.
Yeah. Did you make the room private?
I had to flex that. Man, you know I don't know how to make rooms. Yes, I did.
Damn it, Abe.
Well, you guys have
did you go offline? Did you go offline?
Huh?
Yeah, up here offline, bro.
You gotta go up.
Oh.
I'm always in the cut. Whenever it's PSN, I never show my face.
Nah, man. I want my friends to know I got their backs. I'm here. I'm here, baby.
Not me.
Why are people on Twitter making it sound like this record the Raiders set is a bad thing? This is amazing.
If I want someone to know I'm online, I ain't gonna do it through PSN. I'm gonna talk to them. And be like, hey,
I'm losing friends over these lobbies, man.
I know these people.
So that's up, man.
Gabby's all like, who's this bitch? I'm like, hey, bro.
Yeah, that's my mom. Come on.
Take it easy,
oh,
right?
No.
I like that the camera's just on Abe's face right now.
Oh, shit, I forgot to turn it off.
Good old.
Okay, Abe, just say what's up to the people.
Hey, baby. That's not even playing.
Oh. Yeah, Dan, just heads up for everybody.
Oh my god.
Metaphysics Twitter is gonna be like off the hook pretty soon. It's gonna be the best Twitter on the phone. Oh man.
Will they live to win?
Mm-hmm. I don't know, but I'm gonna fight to survive.
No, I stood up! Chip death.
Yeah, that was cheap, bro. You guys know that King of Fighters 13 Evo Championship is not afraid of winning cheaply.
Yeah, for real.
Look at this. No honor.
Oh, what? God damn it.
And this guy says chip death, and then he also plays Nelson.
I can't chip anybody to death. It's fine. I don't ever chip anybody.
Reynold, how do you feel about that?
Never
Nelson?
Cheesing.
Yeah.
It's very hard for him to get in. His weapons are okay, but the fact that he has to work really hard to get in, that sucks.
Man, Gonzo needs to come home so he can give me the frame data on that Benny Maru stand CD. That thing starts up in like 5 frames a max. That thing's fast.
Computer. Oh, I can say good. You can do the replay function.
Oh,
no,
get him!
Reborn! God damn it! Son of a...
Son of a biscuit-eating bulldog.
You see, that's the problem with the boxers. They don't know how to handle these.
None of that Muay Thai shit.
I don't even know what to classify how Benny Maru does. Just knees you in the gut. Like,
yeah.
Benny Maru works at the same bar that Patrick
Swayze. Roadhouse?
Yeah,
Roadhouse.
He's the cooler.
But can Patrick Swayze, tell us about beef?
Look at this.
The butt.
The old, lane switch kick, man.
It's over, Gibby. I'm done. I'm done playing wild. It's gonna be. I'm gonna be all lame.
Leave the wild for us, bro.
Can you do it? Can you fight to survive?
I'm gonna block. 90% of the round.
Why does he need a Rambo super?
I don't know. Why does Terry need a hat?
Because he's like Hulk Hogan under there.
Oh, that sounded good.
This dude like takes showers with it.
He's got some serious hat hair in this game. It's pretty gross.
He does.
Because before he like pulled it back, now he just like lays it back and he just got like the rat tail going on or something. Like, I don't know what's going on.
Oh, I got him! It's it!
You got me.
This is how he got sponsored, everybody.
Yeah.
Show me your pog champ, chat.
Obviously, this is a testament to Kill being a weak character.
Chris, get out of the room.
Yeah, the room.
So, kick out this Resident Evil KOF. No.
Oh shit! No.
I'm really
let me
upset.
Leave.
Yeah, he's rage quit on the guy.
Yes, I'm a rage
pull the plug.
I can't kick him because he's in.
No, now you can kick him. Kick him now. Kick him now.
Kick him now.
Dude's like suck. Right, like,
I could have kicked him.
Screw it. Okay, kick him out. Kick him out. Kick him out.
You can't kick him out because he's in the fucking. They don't let you kick him out because they're in the game.
He's not in the game no more.
Shut off, okay.
No, like once they're in.
No.
He said, sup. Damn this guy. Somebody get in the next match with me on the bottom. I'm gonna go.
I'm coming back. I'm almost in.
Kick him out.
I can't. Somebody else has to get in the spot.
Yeah, I'm in here right now.
Chris, so, get ready to get in the
both
spot.
Both of you get in this room?
What spot?
Chris.
No. Reynald, get out of there. Come in the room down here.
Get ready. 1, 2, 3, go! Go, get in there!
Get in there.
What's happening? What are we doing?
Oh my god! Oh, I was about to say, dude.
Hold on.
Chris, you idiot. What are you doing?
I got him, dude. I got him. Jeez. Right
over here.
I faked him out.
Let's
don't
go.
Worry about it.
All right, run to the back. Chris, get out.
No, screw you!
No, Chris, get out.
There we go.
This is
so complicated.
Oh my god.
It shouldn't be this complicated, everybody.
No, we gotta call audible on that one. Like, get out of there.
Yeah, these is... No gyms, okay?
No gym
video.
See, you know, okay, hold on. Yeah, see, Ren just taking credit for Hell Pocket's victory.
Oh wow.
Not,
really?
He's not necessarily taking credit, he's just saying I shouldn't have asked him to pick you.
Jeez. The fact that you can't kick someone sitting in position is the stupidest thing.
Yeah.
The fact that you can't just straight up make people can't join your room too is also really dumb.
Don't want to be rude.
Yes, I do.
You want to be extremely rude.
It won't let me, though. Look, buddy, you weren't supposed to be here in the first place.
Hey, all I know is that if this rotation goes down and the only person that beats Reynolds is me, I'm still the best one here.
All I'm trying to say is if they don't got a stonecutter's ring, they ain't coming in.
Oh, the confirm!
God damn it.
No gym should be the lobby name.
We only have room for one gym, and that's Jimmy C, James Chan, and he ain't even here.
Wait, you didn't say Jim Carrey?
No, not Jim Carrey.
Not even like 1989 to 1993 Jim Carrey?
Maybe.
That was good Jim Carrey.
Don't
I play him over James Chan anyway?
Dude, why is that so fucking hard to block?
Last thing I heard about Jim Carrey is he gave some chick VD or something.
Oh.
Isn't he married?
Yeah, or
no,
he wasn't.
No, his girl like just a... died.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like she had a mental issue or something.
Wow.
Yeah, some wild shit's been happening in his life.
I mean, it's Jim Carrey, so.
Yeah. And all I can do is just go alrighty then, and that's it.
What is it? Fireman.
Fire Marshal? Fire Marshal, bro.
Let me show you something!
Let me show you something. I dip my hand in this liquid ice cream.
That's the one I think about the most. That's the one I always think about.
Such a good character. And it drove me nuts, so they talked about making a Fire Marshal film movie for like 5 years in early to the 90s. It never happened.
That would have ruined the character, probably. That would have made it shitty.
Damn.
Great.
It would have just been like 90 minutes of him setting himself on fire or some shit. Or putting a nail through his hand.
It would basically be Jackass pre Jackass.
Yeah, dramatic Jackass.
And if I don't see you, good morning and afternoon and go fuck yourself. That's how a man on, or not man on the moon, I'm mixing all these movies up. That's the one of Andy Cop. Man. Why'd you have to bring up Jim Carrey? Now I'm thinking about every movie he's been in.
Just think about one thing.
Oh man, that was a pretty good one. I haven't seen that in a while, though.
That's a VHS or something.
Kyokuken Ryu Aogi.
Ah, let him have it!
Why?
What? Yeah, what was that about?
Would that not have killed?
It wouldn't have killed.
Yeah.
He would have had three bars, yeah. Hey, fuck it, whatever, got the job done. I respect it.
At least one of us does.
Oh, no.
Wrong super. I meant this one. There you go.
Oh, dear.
Oh, no.
Whoa, is that Volcano Rosso's super? He stomps on your face like... No, I'm talking about Street Fighter EX, dude.
No. Alright, so is this the last match?
This is the last match. I think it's Tony's turn? Or is it your turn, no. Gibby's?
Gibby's turn. Gibby's. Set your buttons, Gibby. Hit the options
Gibby's
button. Turn.
Gibby's sup.
This dude was like, sup.
Yo, sup. This is Resident Evil KOF.
Sup, dude.
This guy's seriously the master of lockpicking. He made his way in here. Member select. Steel, get this memory foam pillow. He says Matsuru, okay?
Matsuru! That's not what it sounds like when I hear it through Gibby's mic.
Fuck you!
It sounds like
it's the Iron Sheik wearing a dinosaur mask. I don't know why people keep saying this is T-Zoc. It's definitely Iron Sheik.
The Iron Sheik of dinosaurs?
No, it is Iron Sheik.
If that's true, then where's his Cobra Clutch?
It's an OTG.
What the hell? Roll out.
I got really tripped up when I didn't realize who was playing Gong and who was playing Kyo. It could have been either of these people.
Dude, yeah, every Netsuzan is like what it should be for Kim.
Oh, that was super! Oh. I'm a dead.
Oh no!
Dude.
Oh no, he's alive!
From Fire Marshal Bill to Mr. Bill.
Yeah, it sucked. I did super and I got grounded counter here. I didn't get the super.
I just realized that this Game Goons, shit's a bust because all we talked about is stuff from the 80s. I definitely only lived in the 80s for like a few months, okay? I was not cognizant of anything that was going on.
Charles in charge? Was that an 80s?
Oh no!
I don't know.
Close enough.
Get ready for the Game Goons Illuminati movie stream where we watch Teen Wolf.
Down shit.
Oh.
Hey. Oh, he tried to go for it.
Didn't work.
Player two, nope. I've seen that before.
He's like, I played dinner with this. Alright, Dan, okay.
Dinner time, baby. This guy's going for the early bird dinner. It's only 2:35.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you son of a bitch.
He's gonna put the camera on Gibby's face the entire time he's playing Dinosaur.
Oh, let me get it.
It was me all along, Bogard.
I want to be Scott Baio for Halloween.
Why not Scott Steiner?
John Steiner?
Yeah. Oh, man.
Big Bad Beauty Daddy?
I want to go as the... I want to go as the entirety of New Kids on the Block.
You just like do that thing you like, you and like five other old dummies.
Well, the best part is you're on stream right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, I know. And people are gonna be like, what the fuck are you looking at? Oh, man. That was the sound thrashing right there.
Yeesh. Hey, so that's it. I think we're done. First episode of Trip Guardians in the books.
You did it! We did it!
And I did not screw it up. I'm so proud of myself.
Y'all screwed it up. Next time I want in more. It should be Gibby and then me and then the rest of you guys. Not this one PS4, one match thing. I'm getting DQ'd over here. What happens if Gibby wins? And then I have to play.
Oh, that's a good point.
No, you just sit there and play with yourself, huh?
Oh.
Just do what you do every day, bro.
Alright, well, we went a little bit over time. This is supposed to be an hour show, but I think we were having so much fun and we had to, make sure the audio issues were not destroying the quality of the program. So, I think we did a pretty good job of that. We're probably going to try to do this weekly. This is sort of a soft launch. I guess we'll do something next weekend also, if anybody's down.
Yeah, so we'd like to thank our special guest, Reynald, for showing up today. Evil Champ. So here's something that gets me. People say former Evil Champ. You won. You still have that title. You were Evil Champ, so you still are an Evil Champ. Remember that. Be sure to follow him on Twitter. He is at ReynoldJT. He's eventually going to post more. Right, Reynald?
Eventually.
See? Let me take over your Twitter, too. I'm going to take over everyone's Twitter and just make him great.
Make Reynolds Twitter drink for once.
Yeah, thank you for not saying again. But yeah, be sure to follow him. Follow us on.
Oh fuck!
I definitely almost ruined my laptop.
Mm-hmm. We almost destroyed everything. So be sure to follow us on Twitter. We're at GameGoonsTV. All our names are right there. There's Hell Pockets. There's Manchester Walkman. Jackass is right here next to me. He's doing dumb shit. Metaphysics is meta_Abe. And once again, Reynold is at ReynoldJT. Be sure to follow our YouTube. We need, 13, 14 more subscribers?
I think we're almost there. And at the end of the month, they're going to reevaluate.
More. Yeah.
Drop that link, player.
Link.
I got it.
It's on there. thetinyurl.com/gamegoons. I think that still works. Cool.
Go ahead, click on that, players.
And Reynold, what's the next tournament you think we'll be at?
NEC.
NEC? Ooh, Steam Old People, NEC? I like this. Don't you have a history of winning every NEC you go to?
Yeah. No. Won the last one. I lost the last one. I think I got fourth the last one, actually.
So Abe, when are you going to start your own solo Game Goon show and play Ir a la Playa?
La Playa?
Yeah.
I
let's
don't know.
Go to the beach. Yeah, we party on the sand, girl.
Uh-oh.
Video X goons.
Oh, my God.
So, anyway, Reynold, do you have any parting words for everybody?
Thanks for having me. It was fun.
Thanks for showing up.
Thanks.
Hold that.
We'll eventually try to bring you on again, so that way we can exact our revenge, and this time you can humiliate Hill Pocket instead of.
I don't need any revenge. I got it. Hold that star dunk.
Oh my God! It's all Ringe's fault. Ringe, you son of a bitch.
Good night, everybody.
Yep.
Take it easy.